At the end of this lesson, you will be able to describe the best practices of organizing source category values in Sumo Logic. Source category is a completely open metadata tag, which means you can enter any value you like. This field is created when you enter text into the source category field when configuring a collector or a source. Setting source category values, especially for a small set of sources, may seem trivial at first. A well-designed convention for defining source categories is important. You will leverage the source category metadata field along with other metadata when you run log and metric queries of searches, set up partitions and scheduled views, which are indexes that can optimize the search experience, configure search filters that govern what data users can view using Sumo Logic's role-based access control or RBAC functionality. Using the naming convention described here allows you to easily and effectively define the scope of your search. You can also use wildcards to define your data scope as partitions or indexes. To improve performance, you can also create a partition by applications such as prod/networking or sales/strategic/myapp. Source categories are useful. When you set up RBAC, you assign users to roles, for example, analyst or collector manager. The data that a user can view is governed by the search filters associated with the user's roles. You use source categories and other metadata to create a role search filter. Regarding best practices, you have the flexibility to name your source category. The four boxes provide examples of how you can name your source category metadata. Note that the more specific source level tags override the more general collector level tags. Let's look at the common types of source categories here. You can build high level groupings with a variety of items. For example, you can group by environment details, such as prod versus dev, geographical information, such as east versus west, by application, by business unit, or any other value that makes sense for your data. The order in which you use these values is determined by how you search the data. In these examples, we are more commonly going to search by separating out production from development. You can also divide searches by web and databases. We hope this video helps you set up source category values. Thank you for joining.